सदाशिव समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यंतां वंदे गुरु परंपरा। ओम सहना भवतु सहनो भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ओम शांति शांति शांति। सुखं नित्यं स्वप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूपयोः अधिष्ठानं बुद्धबोध्यं बुद्धिर्द्रव्यत्तु निर्मलम् अपारं सर्वभेदांत वेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं महः तदेवाहं नमत्तोऽन्यदिति मे निश्चिता मतिः।
We had completed the 12th avarta in which the objection was raised, at the end the objection was raised regarding the need for this book when many other books such as Brahma Sutra and Vartika on that etc. are there, and it was said that the utility of this book is that it is beneficial to the slow learners. All those books are very advanced books, not accessible to everybody. And now, in the 13th avarta, one possible objection is answered. The objection is, even for slow learners, there are lots of books in vernacular languages. Then still, why is the need for this particular book, Vichara Sagara? And that is answered now. It is said, Satsu api anekeshu bhasha grantheshu pancha bhashatma bodhadishu vina vichara sagaram svatma vishayaka sarva saunshayaha na nivarteran. Even though there are many books in vernacular languages such as pancha bhasha, atma bodha, etc., still, without Vichara Sagara, without this text, all doubts regarding the self, regarding the nature of oneself, will not be resolved by those granthas. And why do you say so? That is said now. The reason is given. Yataha kechan granthakaraha shravana matram krutva bhasha grantham rachaya masuhu. Since some authors have composed their text in vernacular language having done mere shravanam, and it means that they have done only shravanam, they have not done mananam nididhyasanam. Can we also take in that way that they have not done mananam nididhyasanam?
Nididhyasanam is done, then Jnana Nishtha is there. So certain things they can say very clearly with conviction. Otherwise, doubtful. Nididhyasanam also.
And also, even the Shravanam they have done is not of the Moola Grantha. They have done Shravanam of translated works. And therefore, their understanding of what is there in Shastra is not very clear. And therefore what happens? Tataha tadgata vishayaha kechan shastranusarinaha na bhavanti. Therefore, because of that reason
is
that they have done shravana matram before composing the text. Because of that reason, some of the topics which are there in their books are not according to Shastra. And also, Vachit, Shastrartha Vaiparityancha Upalabhyate. Vachit, in some places, it is the opposition to the content of Shastra is also found. If I have one set of people, then there are other set of people who अपरे केचन स्वल्प शास्त्राभ्यास मात्रेण भाषा ग्रंथान रचया मासुः. Whereas there are some other people have composed the texts in vernacular languages by only a little bit of Shastra study. That is, they have not even completed their Shravanam. Just a little part of Shastra they studied, and based on that they composed books. And what is the fault in their books? Tatra Vedantarthasya Samagrasya Anuptatvat Na Taihi Nisanchaya Jnanam Udeti. Tatra, in those books, since the entire content of Vedanta is not told, therefore, by those books or by the study of those books, doubtless knowledge will not arise. So far, the problem with the other Bhasha Granthas has been told. And now, the Granthakara tells the speciality of this book. अस्मिन् विचार सागरे तु वेदांतार्थाः समर्मकाः समग्रतया शास्त्रानुसारेण प्रतिपाद्यन्ते. इन दिस टेक्स्ट विचार सागर द कंटेंट्स ऑफ वेदांता आर प्रेजेंटेड. एंड हाउ आर दे प्रेजेंटेड? समर्मकाः अलोंग विद द सीक्रेट्स द सटल नुएंसेस एंड समग्रतया कंप्लीटली and Shastranusarena, in keeping with Shastra. So in this text, the entire content of Vedanta is presented along with the subtle nuances and in keeping with Shastra. And Sarvatra Shastra Virodhena Cha Atma Jnanopayogi Vishayaha Saprapancham Nirupyante. Sarvatra means in every place in this book, आत्मज्ञानोपयोगी विषयः, the topics which are useful for आत्मज्ञानम्, are presented with elaboration and in keeping with Shastra. And here there are two kinds of विषयः, आत्मज्ञानोपयोगी विषयः. One refers to the those विषयः which help in getting the
clarity of the subject matter,
self-knowledge. The other one is preparedness. The one which helps in preparedness, again, making the person prepared, such as Karma Yoga and Upasana. And the other is which helps in getting clarity regarding the subject matter, regarding Atma, being Brahma. And therefore, Tasmar Ayam Eva Sarvebhyah Vedanta Granthebhyah Uttamottamah. Now, in this light, the Granthakara is presenting his Atma Vishwasa. And he is saying, Tasmad. Tasmad, we can take it immediately. The two reasons were given before. That is, in this text, since all the topics are presented along with the subtle nuances, in keeping with Shastra, therefore, this text alone is the best among the best compared to all Vedanta texts. Nasti asti samam granthantaram. There is no other book similar to this book. So with this, the Grantha Mahima part is over. And now, from the next 14th avarta, to 37th avarta, sadhana chatushtaya nirupanam is there. And there in the 14th avarta, anubandha chatushtayam is presented. What is anubandha chatushtayam? It is the fourfold introductory point which, by the help of which, a qualified person is engaged in the study of that particular text.
with the help of his idea, with the help of the knowledge of which merely swarupatana karuti kanya swarnare kanya.
And then anubandha dushtayam is listed in here. अधिकारी विषय प्रयोजन संबंधनानां अधिकारी विषय प्रयोजन संबंधनानां अनुबंध है इति नाम.
What was the mistake you understood? What was the mistake? What was the mistake?
संबंधनानां double type ना के
संबंधनानां
अनुबंध है इति नाम. तो अनुबंध है नाम. Anubandha means adhikara, adhikari, the qualified person, vishaya, the subject matter, prayojana, the purpose, and sambandha, the connection between the text and the prayojana, or the text and the vishaya, iti. And then?
Here one thing, anubandha iti nama I said called yesterday. But that is not correct. Adhikari Vishaya Prayojana Sambandhanam Anubandha iti nama. For all these four introductory points, Anubandha is the name. Okay.
Yes.
Sorry. It's true that point. Means, idea wise is true. All these four things are called Anubandha. But literally translation is that. For all these four, Anubandha is the name.
And then, among these four, the Prayojana is the most important. Because without seeing the Prayojana, even a Dala does not engage in any activity. And here in a Shloka, the importance of Prayojana is told. Sarvasyaivahi Shastrasya. कर्मणो वापि कस्यचित् यावत् प्रयोजनं नोक्तं तावत् तत्केन गृह्यते. It is said, for the entire Shastra or even some karma, as long as the purpose is not told, so long by whom would that Shastra or karma would be grasped, be done, or be studied. So, in this way, the importance of Prayojanam is told.
So, now we are into the topic of Sadhana Chatushtaya Nirupana. And Sadhana Chatushtaya comes under Anubandha Chatushtaya. So, we must know that Sadhana Chatushtaya is bigger or Anubandha Chatushtaya? अधिकारी विषय प्रयोजन संबंधानां अनुबंध इति नाम. फॉर दिस फोर इंट्रोडक्टरी पॉइंट्स अधिकारी the qualified person, vishaya, subject matter, prayojana, the purpose, and sambandha, the connection between the text and the subject matter. There are so many connections this author will talk about. So, all these four introductory points, for them, anubandha is the name. All these four points are called anubandha. Introductory points, or it can be translated as connecting factors. Another good translation I saw. Connecting factors. These four points, through their knowledge, connects the person to the text. That idea we will see in Anubandha, it could not be given. But in simple way, Anubandha are Anubandha Chatushtaya are fourfold factors that connect the person, Viveki Purusha, to the Grantha through its knowledge, through their knowledge. So linking factors, connecting factors. Now, among these four, Prayojana is important. That was explained by a shloka that Sarvasya Shastrasya, the entire Shastra, or any karma. Yavat Prayojanam na Uttam, as long as the benefit or the purpose of the entire Shastra, means any Shastra, or of any karma, as long as the prayojanam is not told, tavat so long, tat karma va shastram kena grihyate, by whom it could be adopted. Kena here is akshepartha. Kena pina grihyate ityartha. By nobody it would be adopted, accepted. Iti vachana, because of this, we have read this, no? इति वचनात्
इति वचनात्
प्रयोजनादिज्ञानाभावे विवेकिनां
विवेकिनां ग्रंथे प्रवृत्त्यनुपपत्तेः तदंगभूतः
अनुबन्धः प्रथमं निरूप्यते
अनुबन्धः प्रथमं निरूप्यते
इति वचनात् बिकॉज ऑफ दिस स्टेटमेंट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ श्लोक इवर्स इन द फॉर्म ऑफ द बिकॉज ऑफ दिस स्टेटमेंट व्हिच इज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ इवर्स प्रयोजनादि ज्ञानाभावे फ्रॉम दिस श्लोक व्हाट डू वी अंडरस्टैंड प्रयोजनादि ज्ञानाभावे हियर प्रयोजन इज मेंशन बट प्रयोजन इज अ उपलक्षण फॉर अदर थ्री Therefore, he says, prayojanadi jnana bhave, in the absence of the knowledge of purpose, etc. Vivekinam, of discriminative people, thinking people, granthe pravritti anupapattehe, because of untenability, impossibility of the engagement in the text. Because of the above mentioned shloka, we understand that since there is untenability of engagement in the text on the part of Viveki, discriminative people, in the absence of Abhave, in the absence of the knowledge of Prayojanadi. In simple words, if Prayojanadi Jnanam is not there, means Anubandha Chatushtaya Jnanam is not there, then, it means Anubandha Chatushtaya with regard to the Grantha, it is not there. Knowledge of the Anubandha Chatushtaya of the text is not there. Then, Vivekinam Pravruttyam Papatte. For Viveki, discriminative people, there will be absence of, there will be untenability or impossibility of the engagement in the text. Means, they will not be engaged to study the text. And here Vivekina means what? The people who value their time. People who have priority about what to do and what not to do. Those who prioritize their time. Some people, they don't have anything to do. They don't have value for their time. So, kuch bhi aaya pad lete. Even the packet, the fruit packet, you know, that newspaper bag is there. So that also they will open and read. We are not talking about that. They can have pravritti even without knowing Anubandha Chatushtaya. It is not that person says, what is the Anubandha, then I will study. Not that. But we are talking about Viveki. This Grantha is meant for Viveki. And Viveki Purusha, discriminative thinking people, will have pravritti only after knowing Anubandha. So, Vivekinam Granthe Pravruti will be there only after the knowledge of this Anubandha Chatushtaya. Without that, Pravruti Anupapattehe. Since there is impossibility of the engagement in the Grantha on the part of Viveki, in the absence of the knowledge of Prayojanadi, therefore, Tadanga Bhutaha. तदंगभूत मीन्स ग्रंथ अंगभूत शास्त्र अंगभूत अनुबंध अनुबंध मीन्स इंट्रोडक्ट लिंकिंग फैक्टर्स प्रथमं निरूप्यते इज प्रेजेंटेड फर्स्ट Now, the first footnote is there about Anubandha. It gives a good definition of Anubandha. It says, Stambha Chatushtaya Bhave Yatha. Just as in the absence of the four pillars, Mandapaha has got different meanings. One is a temple or a house. न तिष्ठति जनरली फोर समबडी मे डू इट टू आल्सो बट जनरली देयर बी फोर पिलर्स सो न तिष्ठति किं न तिष्ठति मंडपः द हाउस कैन नॉट स्टैंड इन द एब्सेंस ऑफ द फोर पिलर्स तद्वत् सिमिलरली अनुबंध चतुष्टया भावे इन द एब्सेंस ऑफ दिस फोर लिंकिंग फैक्टर्स न कस्यापि ग्रंथे प्रवृत्ति सिद्धे कस्यापि ऑफ एनीवन ऑफ एनी पर्सन एस्पेशली विवेकिनः ग्रंथे प्रवृत्ति एंगेजमेंट इन द टेक्स्ट एंड एंगेजमेंट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ स्टडीइंग द टेक्स्ट इन द एब्सेंस ऑफ अनुबंध चतुष्टय ग्रंथे प्रवृत्ति एंगेजमेंट इन द टेक्स्ट कस्यापि फॉर एनीवन न सिद्धे वुड नॉट बी अकॉम्प्लिश्ड वुड नॉट बी एस्टैब्लिश्ड मीन्स इन अनुबंध चतुष्टय इज नॉट मेंशन नॉट देयर इन द टेक्स्ट देन एनीवन विल नॉट हैव द एंगेजमेंट एनी विवेकी पुरुष विल नॉट हैव एंगेजमेंट इन द ग्रंथ यू ऑलवेज नो व्हाट इज द कंटेंट हाउ विल बी बेनिफिशियल देन ओनली यू स्टडी तस्मात् देयरफॉर ग्रंथादौ इन द बिगिनिंग ऑफ द टेक्स्ट प्रवृत्त्यर्थं तत्र मीन्स ग्रंथे प्रवृत्त्यर्थं फॉर द पर्पस ऑफ एंगेजमेंट इन द टेक्स्ट अवश्यं नेसेसरीली ग्रंथकर्त्रा बाय द ऑथर ऑफ द टेक्स्ट तच्चतुष्टयम् मीन्स अनुबंध चतुष्टयम् द फोर फोल्ड लिंकिंग फैक्टर्स इंट्रोडक्टरी पॉइंट्स निरूपणीयम् शुड बी प्रेजेंटेड सिंस विदाउट अनुबंध द एंगेजमेंट ऑफ विवेकी वुड नॉट बी एस्टैब्लिश्ड इन द टेक्स्ट देयरफॉर बाय द ऑथर ऑफ द टेक्स्ट दिस अनुबंध चतुष्टय शुड बी मेंशन इन द बिगिनिंग इटसेल्फ It is not that, in the course of reading, we will find out what is Anubandha. That is not proper. In the beginning itself, it should be mentioned. Alright. Now, he gives the definition of Anubandha. Derivation. Anubandha has got two parts, Anu and Bandha. Anu means after. And Bandha here means Bandhatiti Bandha. Kartarit Vyutpatti. He says, स्वज्ञानम अनु आफ्टर इट्स नॉलेज स्वपदेन अनुबंधस्य ग्रहणं आफ्टर द नॉलेज ऑफ अनुबंध मीन्स स्वविवेक विज्ञानानंतरमेव ओनली आफ्टर द नॉलेज ऑफ वंस डिस्टिंक्ट नॉलेज हियर विवेक विज्ञान मीन्स डिस्टिंक्ट नॉलेज means after the knowledge of anubandha alone mumukshu granthena with the text bhagnati ties anubandha is that which ties the mumukshu with the text so is a linking factor anubandha is that which ties the mumukshu with the text when anu after its knowledge. And Badnati means what? You cannot type physically. Imagine that mumukshu is tied with a book. Wherever he goes, the book will be there. So, the Baddha is like that. So, Granthena Baddhati is Vedanta Vichare Pravartayati. Anubandha Chatushtaya Pravartayati means motivates in the analysis, the study of Vedanta. So, he is giving the contextual definition. So, Anubandha is that which motivates the person to study Vedanta. And how he motivates? Through its knowledge. So, Anubandha is that which through its knowledge motivates the person to study Vedanta. Or motivates the person into the study of Vedanta. Vichare pravartayati iti anubandha. So, what is the vitpatti? Anu, jnanam, mumukshum, badnati iti anubandha. Anu Dhanam Mumukshum Granthena, we can say Granthena Badnati Iti Anubandha. This is Kartari Vitpatti. So that which links the Mumukshu to the text means the study of the text is called Anubandha. And Karmani also we can give based on this. Anu Swagdhanam Anu Mumukshuhu granthena badhyate anena. Anu svagnanam anu mumukshuhu granthena badhyate anena. Okay, so double tritiya is there. Anubandha is that by which mumukshu is tied to the text after its knowledge. Anena iti anubandha. So anubandhas are linking factors connecting a viveki to the text. Now, after giving this introduction, general introduction of anubandha chatushtaya, now he goes to the particular one. The first one is adhikari nirupanam. In Anubandha, four are there. Adhikari Vishaya Prayojana Sambandha. There is a shloka also. Adhikarishcha Vishayaha Sambandhascha Saprayojanaha Sambandhascha Saprayojanaha. Just not do that. One little. Sambandhascha Saprayojanaha Sambandhascha. Shastrarambhe, Shastrarambham, Phalam Proktam, Shastrarambha Phalam Proktam. One samasa can be there. Shastrarambha Phalam Proktam, Anubandha Chatushtayam. So these four points, which are having the Shastrarambha as a Phalam, Gauri, Shastrarambham, Phalam Yasya. That is called Anubandha Chatushtaya. Vishaya Adhikari Prayojana Sambandha. These four linking factors which are having the beginning of the Shastra as the result is called Anubandha Chatushtaya. Now Adhikari Nirupanam. In that adhikari lakshanam. Nisargataha eva.
Nisargataha eva.
Sarvesham antahkarane.
Sarvesham antahkarane.
Malavikshepavaranatmaka doshatrayam aste.
Malavikshepavaranatmaka doshatrayam aste.
Nishkama karma anushthanena.
Nishkama karma anushthanena.
Antahkaranastha malarupa dosha nivrittihi.
Antah
करणस्थमलरूपदोषनिवृत्ति
उपासनया विक्षेपस्य
उपासनया विक्षेपस्य
यस्य निष्कामकर्मोपासनाभ्याम्
यस्य निष्कामकर्मोपासनाभ्याम्
मलविक्षेपयोः निवृत्तौ अपि
मलविक्षेपयोः निवृत्तौ अपि
स्वस्वरूपावरकाज्ञानं न निवृत्तम्
स्वस्वरूपावारकाज्ञानं न निवृत्तम्
यः च पुष्करसाधनचतुष्टयसम्पन्नः
यः च पुष्करसाधनचतुष्टयसम्पन्नः
सः अधिकारी
सः अधिकारी गुजराती में बोलते हैं कि अगर लिखा है तो पढ़ा जाएगा। ओके। निसर्गतः एव मींस नेचुरली अलोन मींस सिंस बर्थ और टाइम बिगिनिंगलेस since time beginningless anaditah eva nisarga has got one meaning naisargiko yam loka vyavahara naisargika has got meaning anadi so nisargata eva means naturally without any effort on your part what सर्वेषां अंतःकरणे इन द माइंड्स ऑफ ऑल इन द माइंड ऑफ ऑल दोषत्रयम् आस्ते थ्री फोल्ड डिफेक्ट्स स्टेज रिमेन्स इज प्रेजेंट दोषत्रयम् पढ़ा दोषत्रयम् मल विक्षेप आवरणात्मक थ्री फोल्ड डिफेक्ट्स आत्मक इन द फॉर्म ऑफ mala impurity vikshepa disturbance or restlessness and avarna veiling ignorance so in the mind of everyone these threefold doshas are there nisargatah eva naturally means it is not that the person he did something now in this janma and therefore yes these are there unless he works on them they will not go they will be there that's a very good thing nisargata means what hum to paida hi aise ho we are born like this so we need not feel guilty about it only we should take responsibility for not removing it so far many time chances there but hum school gaye nahi did not go to school so but they are there so nisargatah eva sarvesham antakarane mala vikshepa avranatmaka doshatrayam asti okay further nishkama karma anushthanena we see the footnote after saying it Ha ha ha.
After saying the mula, we will say the footnote. I learned. I am happy you remembered. Nishkama karma anushthanena. By the performance of the karma, not motivated by materialistic desire. By the performance of actions, not motivated by the materialistic desire. Or without materialistic desire. We can simply say, by the performance of actions without materialistic desire. Why we say that? Because desire is there. Chitta Shuddhi desire is there. Therefore we cannot say without any desire. Unnecessary complex. Or without materialistic desire. So by that, otherwise called karma yoga. So nishkama karma anushthanena karma yogena antakarnastha malarupa dosha nivruttihi. The removal of the defect in the form of impurity which is there in the mind. Clear? So simple. Three doshas are there. Now threefold solutions are there. And the first solution is that mala is impurity is removed by karma yoga. Second is what? Upasanaya vikshepasya. You have to supply what?
Nivritti.
So removal of vikshepa, restlessness of the mind by upasana, meditation. And now, who is adhikari? Yasya, a person for whom nishkama karma upasana bhyam by vikarma without materialistic desire and upasana meditation, mala vikshepa yoho of mala and vikshepa nivrutto vapi, even though it is removed, even though there is removal of mala and vikshepa by nishkama karma and upasana for whom, for whichever person, but swasvarupavaraka agnanam na nivruttam. Two problems are solved. Mala and vikshepa, two problems are solved by karma yoga and upasana. But swasvarupa varaka avaraka agnanam na nivruttam. That agnanam is not removed. What type of agnanam? Swasvarupa avaraka. Avaraka means veiling. The ignorance which is veiling the swasvarupa. Means veiling means what? It is leading me to the, it is the basis for the conclusion, I do not know Brahman. It will be said that what is the avaraka agnanam? The agnanam which is the basis for the hetu. That I do not know akhanda chinmatra Brahma. I don't know. What is this Brahman? That agnanam is na nivruttam. So this is also important. A person who has removed mala and vikshepa, can you say that all those people who have removed mala and vikshepa, they are adhikari? Can we say? Why?
Because we see there are people who have removed mala and vikshepa but are not yet having wisdom. We see people who have removed mala and vikshepa but yet to have wisdom.
Ativyakti.
Where?
In wise people.
Ah, see, miss the point. Ativyakti. It is adhikari, they are adhikari only. Mala vikshepa removed adhikari. But if you simply say that mala vikshepa diska chala gaya, who was removed, they are adhikari, then dhani also will be adhikari. Is dhani adhikari? Not adhikari. Isn't it? If somebody has already attained, he is not adhikari. So if somebody has already, what is called, entered the house, he is not an adhikari to enter the house because he is already inside. Because first, Swasvarupa avaraka अज्ञानम न निवृत्तम दैट आल्सो मेक्स क्वालिफाइड देयरफॉर इन हनुमाना दे से दैट साध्य शुड नॉट बी सिद्ध शिशादैशा शुड बी देयर सो साध्य इज सिद्ध फॉर द पर्सन देन हनुमाना विल नॉट वर्क सो हनुमाना विल वर्क when sadhya is to be established as that is why siddha sadhanata is one dosha meaning that is a two come about it sometime okay swaswarupa varaka agnanam na nivruttam yascha and also he supply pushkala sadhana chatushtaya sampannaha he is adding one more point what and one who is sampannaha endowed with पुष्कल साधन चतुष्टय पुष्कल मीन्स सफिशिएंट पर्याप्त वन हु इज एंडोर्ड विथ द फोर फोल्ड हु इज एंडोर्ड विथ सफिशिएंट फोर फोल्ड मीन्स सफिशिएंट फोर फोल्ड क्वालिफिकेशंस पुष्कल मीन्स पर्याप्त अपेक्षित पुष्यति पुष्पिं गच्छति अनेन इति पुष्कल और पुष्कम पुष्टि ही महत्वम तदस्य इति पुष्कल इट कैन बी तद्धिता इट कैन बी कृदंता आल्सो एंड तद्धिता आल्सो इफ इज अ कृदंता देन पुष धातु कलन प्रत्यय एंड इफ इज तद्धिता then pushka plus lach pratyaya
second one swami
pushka plus lach
the second derivative
pushkam pushtihi pushkam is equal to pushtihi is equal to mahatvam tadasti asti iti pushpalam pushkam is the pushti nourishment greatness sufficiency one who has got is called pushkala and pushkala when pushyati pushtihi gachyati anena primarily it is used for diksha diksha which is enough for nourishing the person that is called pushkala chaturgrasatmaka ग्रास चतुष्टयात्मक भिक्षा आई डोंट नो बाय फोर ग्रास दे विल हैव चतुष्टय एंड दिस बाय द वे बट हियर फॉर अस पुष्कल मींस अबंडेंट और सफिशिएंट एंड सफिशिएंट डजंट मीन 100% वी हैव सीन दिस पुष्कल मींस इट शुड बी इनफ टू मेक द पर्सन क्वालिफाइड इट शुड बी इनफ टू मेक द पर्सन रिमेन फोकस्ड ऑन श्रवण मंदन निधिध्यास दैट मच दैट इज पुष्कल कारण यस्मिन् सति कार्यम निष्पद्यते दैट मच इज रिक्वायर्ड टू मेक लड्डू यू डोंट हैव टू पोर व्हाट एवर शुगर यू हैव पूरा स्टोर रूम से पूरा डालना नहीं है वी डोंट हैव टू पुट द होल शुगर We have put sugar by which the laddu will be laddu. So similarly, Pushkala has got that meaning. The paryaptata, sufficiency, is conveyed by the word Pushkala. So yascha Pushkala sadhana chatushtaya sampanna. By Pushkala, what is suggested? Natu alpa sadhana chatushtaya sampanna. Just little bit viveka is there, Swamiji. I know that. Brahman is great. Other things are not so great, but they are also great, Swami. So some viveka is there, some vairagya is there. Swamiji, when somebody hurts me, no, I have a lot of vairagya. Vairagya is there. And in Shastra, in Mahabharata, it is said, after certain bhoga, person gets to some state of the dejection. And he says, I don't want certain bhoga. But that doesn't remain for long time. Like sometimes, you know, you have a heavy meal. Then you say, I don't want to eat today, whole day. Happens sometimes. बट स्लोली बाय द टाइम 4 o'clock 5 o'clock नहीं थोड़ा कुछ खा सकते एनीवे सो दैट दैट इज लिटिल बिट मेड आई गया दिस शम दमा लिटिल बिट इज दैट स्वामी जी व्हेन आई माय बॉस इज देयर देन आई टिप क्वाइट नो थोड़ा दम तो है माने जो शम दमा तितिक्षा बट नॉट इनफ देयरफॉर पुष्कला साधन चतुष्टय संपन्न सह अधिकारी सो इट लुक्स लाइक द टीकाकार हियर ग्रंथकार इज कंसीडरिंग साधन चतुष्टय संपत्ति समथिंग ओवर एंड अबव मल विक्षेप देयरफॉर व्हाट यू सेड विल बी राइट इन दिस वर्जन बट जनरली वी इक्वेट दैट मल विक्षेप निवृत्ति एंड साधन चतुष्टय संपत्ति कैन बी इक्वेटेड But some quality will may not be covered like Shraddha. But generally when Mala is not there, Shraddha will be there. So some sadhana chatushtaya sampatti, all qualities are included directly or indirectly in Mala Vikshepa Nivruti. But it can be separately mentioned. So here it is separately mentioned. So who is Adhikari? Let us understand. Adhikari is the one who has removed mala by karma yoga, who has removed vikshepa by upasana, and who has got sadhana chatushtaya sampatti, but whose ignorance is not removed. That person is the adhikari. Somebody is there? Yes, open. Please, is open.
I'm so sorry to disturb
you. Police officer
is here to verify.
No problem. Good, you came. This is good. Now we'll see the picture. Yes. Second footnote. Mala, etc. No? So he says, if the footnote is on Mala Vikshepa Varanatmaka Dosha Prema. So first general note he gives. Stula Deha Gata वात पित्त श्लेष्म रूप दोष त्रय जन्य रोग निवृत्तये फॉर रिमूवल ऑफ द डिसीज रोग जन्य बर्न ऑफ दोष त्रय थ्री फोल्ड दोष थ्री फोल्ड डिफेक्ट्स इन द फॉर्म ऑफ व्हाट वात पित्त श्लेष्म Vata means wind, Pitta means, they have got some name for that. Vata, Pitta. Pitta literally means mild. And flesh, cough. Or flame, flame they call it, flame. Flame, yeah. PH, what is this?
PHLEGM.
Flame, that flame. Okay. So that flame. Flame this three dosha, roga for removal of the disease which is born of threefold doshas such as vata, pitta, shleshma, which are gata obtaining in the cross body. So for the removal of the roga, born of these three dosha obtaining in the body, yatha, just as धन्वंतरी प्रवृति विहि बाय धन्वंतरी सुश्रुता चरका बाय देम आयुर्वेदः प्राणायि आयुर्वेदा वास प्राणायि विच फॉर्म यू माइट नॉट हैव स्टडीड दिस इज आउट ऑफ सिलेबस
लुंग लक्कर
करेक्ट दैट पास 50% But how pranayi? Ninaya it happened, no?
There are seven
forms. No, I should tell you, not keeping suspense. It's a karmani prayoga. Pra, ni, and karmani prayoga pranayi. So I think the lunglakara, means the simple form will be anai. Here prapurvaka ni dhatu is there. Therefore pranai. And also it was not found anywhere. I put it in the Golden Dictionary, it is not there. But Swamiji had told, therefore I know pranai. Okay, is a karmani prayoga. Generally we karmani and lung we used to do rare combination. Okay, pranayama means was composed. Prapurvaka ni dhatu has the meaning of to compose. So what is the meaning? For removal of the disease, just as for the removal of disease, Ayurveda was composed by Dhanvantari and others, evam similarly. Sarva prani sadharana antahkarna gata mala vikshepadana nanakya doshatraya nivruttaye. For the removal of doshatraya, three-four defects. What are those three-four defects? Mala, impurity, vikshepa, restlessness and agdana. Called this agdanakya. For the removal of the three-four dosha called mala, vikshepa, agdanam, which are gata, obtaining in the antahkarna. And which are sadharana, common to, these doshas are common. Common to what? Sarva prani, all living beings. So for the removal of threefold dosha called mala vikshepa avarana, obtaining in the antakarana, and which are common to all living beings. For removal of those three doshas, karma upasana dana kanda trayopa brahmhitam veda chatushtayam ishvarena akari. Akari. So now you can tell. Akari was done. Lung lakara karmani priyoga. Krudhatu. So for removal of this threefold dosha of the antakarana, Veda chatushtayam, fourfold Vedas, was done by the Lord. Yo brahmanam vidadati purvam Veda. Done by Ishvara means what? Manifested by Ishvara. What type of Veda chatushtayam? Upabrumhitam. Veda chatushtayam, which is with, along with, accompanied by. Kandatraya, three sections. Veda chatushtaya, along with the three sections. What are those? Karma, upasana, dana. Three sections, namely, karma kanda, action section, upasana, the meditation section, and dana, atmagdana section. Self-knowledge section. So, just as for removing the disease of the physical body, Ayurveda was composed, similarly for removing the threefold dosha of the antakarana, Veda is composed, manifested. What type of Veda? Karma, upasana, dana, kanda. Veda, four Vedas, which are endowed with these three sections. Karma kanda, upasana kanda, dana kanda. And how, what is the connection of this three kanda with the dosha traya? For mala, karma kanda. For vikshepa, upasana kanda. And for our agdana, dana kanda. So this three kanda, the Vedas with this three kanda was done by Ishvara. This is a general note. Now he explains each one of them. Malam nama papam. Mala means papam. Duradrishta. Papa. The result of, invisible result of prohibited action. Pratishiddha karma janya adrishta phalam is papam. Tacha. And that papam. Samskaratmana atisukshmatvat na pratyakshi kriyate. Na pratyakshi kriyate means what? Not perceived. Panchak dhanindriyehi na vishari kriyate. This papa is not, tat means papam. Papam is not perceived by the sense organs. Why? samskaratpana, being in the form of samskara, the impressions. Patisukshmatva, being very subtle. Because of being very subtle, on account of being in the form of impressions, tat papam na pratyakshi kriyate, is not perceived. Is it clear? So immediate hetu for apratyakshi karanam is what? Atisukshma. And why atisukshma? Because it is samskara rupa. Samskara rupa means what? It is the impression form of the karma done by the person. It's like in a, now we can understand with the help of chips. It's the chips, how well is the only samskaras are there? Not that whole the objects in gross form, that they are only in the form of samskaras. So only impressions are there. So here also they are these in the antakarana or in karana sharira, these karmas have created impressions. And Bhagavan has done this system. This is mainly based on the Mimamsaka's view. That you carry your own account. Like in your mobile, in your SIM, your account is there. So if you put money, then what? Your SIM card will have charge. Recharge will be more. It will show more account. So Bhagavan says, aapka SIM card hai, usma aapka account hai. So whatever plus minus you have done. Nowadays people have no online. It is there in their mobile only. In the mobile only, it is only this account, plus is there, minus it, all entries are there. So, this punya papa, being in the form of samskara, the impressions, they are very subtle. And therefore, na pratyakshi kriyate. That is why this papa is called adrushna. People ask this, punya papa kisne dekha hai? There is a very common expression. Means, who has seen punya papa? See, punya papa are adrishta. They are not to be seen. Otherwise, they will not be called adrishta. So, punya papa na pratyakshi kriyate. And if they are not pratyakshi, if they are not perceived, then how do you know they are there? Because dana dhina bhavet siddhi. So, based on dana only siddhi is there. What is that Veya Vakya? Lakshana Pramana Vyamhi Vastu Siddhi. Pramana has got the meaning Dhanam. So, Dhanam and Pramana has got also meaning the Dhanam. Lakshana and Pramana, by that alone, Vastu Siddhi will happen. So if there is no Pramana, Pratyaksha Pramana is not available for Punya Papa, how will we establish Punya Papa? One thing is the Shastra is a Pramana. Other Anumanam also Pramana. That is said here. Kentu means even though papam is not perceived sensorily through sense organs, kentu but nishiddha karma anushthanena vishaya satya chitta gata shubha vasana vihicha anumiyate. This papam anumiyate. How? Nishiddha karma anushthanena. By performance and inclination to prohibited action. What a vicious circle it is. A person has done papa, therefore he will have inclination and performance of nishiddha karma, prohibited action. Therefore what will happen? More papa. And that is true with reference to very situation. I think I have told you some years ago. Now it is not applicable. India is poor because it is poor. Any country is poor because it is poor. Why? Because if the country is poor, it will not have infrastructure. Since infrastructure is not there, the industries will not come. Employment will not be generated. So what? We mean poor. So poverty leads to poverty. Similarly, papa leads to papa. So nishiddha karma anushthanena anumiyate. We have to connect with anumiyate. Papam is inferred by, we have to supply inclination, by the inclination and performance of nishiddha karma. That is why many people say, Swamiji, I know it is wrong, but I can't stop. Duryodhana also says, Janami dharmam nachame pravruttihi, Janamya dharmam nachame nivruttihi, Kenapi devena hrudisthitena yatha prayuktosmi tatha karomi. So that Deva is also in the form of this karma. So nishiddha karma anushthanena. Therefore, when papam is very powerful, person will not stop. He will do that nishiddha karma. So nishiddha karma anushthanena kim? Papam anumiyate. Amen. So free will is there, but your free will is not completely free. Your free will is influenced by prarabdhas. That's why we cannot really draw a demarcating line we cannot draw. That here prarabdha stop and here purushartha start, or here purushartha stop prarabdha. We cannot say. Roughly we have given division. That situation created is by prarabdha and my response is by purushartha. Bowling is by prarabdha, betting is by purushartha. That is the definition. Purushartha keeps on bowling and I do betting. Alright. But this here it is not so. In fact, present for Sachin Tendulkar it was said, he had that capacity to make the bowler ball in a particular way. And sometimes bowling is so much that you are betting, you don't have a chance. You cannot bet the way you want to bet, isn't it? The bowler bowls in such a way that even though this fellow wants to hit, he can't hit. It goes somewhere down this side, so he can't. He tries. Sometimes in the attempt of trying, a little bit cut will be there, touch out. And therefore, full freedom is not there. Batsman doesn't have full freedom. If you have full freedom, then you will never get out. Every ball you will hit six only. Isn't it? But some freedom is there. How much is there really, he cannot decide. Therefore, he gets out also. Big batsman gets out. Anyway, so nishiddha karma anushthanena kim anumiyate papa manumiyate. This will give us some sympathy to the people who are doing nishiddha karma anushthana. What to do? That person is helpless. Is papam is instigating that person to do more. Vishayasakti. Too much attachment to the objects, that also is indicative of papa. So vairagyam is because of papa nivruti or punyodaya. Both ways we can say. And chittagata ashubha vasana. This ashubha vasana means kama krodhadi vasana. Ashubha vasana means unhealthy tendencies obtaining in the mind. By that also what? Anumiyate. Papa anumiyate. But mainly by these two. The chittagata ashubha vasana itself is little bit apratyaksha. So we have to first do the anumanam of ashubha vasana, and from that we do anumanam of anumitena anumanam. Anumanam of papa. So by these three things, nishiddha karma anushthanam, therefore I told an inclination. In fact, this will take care of inclination. Chittagata ashubha vasana, inclination for doing wrong things, and vishayasakti, the liking or the attachment to the objects. By this three, papam anumiyate. And tadvan purusha malino bhavati. A person who is endowed with this papa, he is impure. And then for Nivruti, Karma Yoga, etc. We'll see in the next class. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Shri Guru Hari Om.